Hey guys, welcome to Titanium Man Garage, and on this episode I'm gonna go through the brakes. So when I picked this thing up, it had some starting issues, got those all resolved, and it's been sitting for a while, I'm guessing a couple years. The master cylinder does not push back out. There was nothing but dust in here. I cleaned that all out. I bought a replacement master cylinder / handbrake. I don't buy the aftermarket ones because they don't seem to hold up. I don't know, just haven't been a big fan of them. So I bought a used one off of 03 Sportsman, works good. Also got myself some guitar string because I believe one of the brake lines is plugged up. I'm guessing a lot of the brake fluid was dried up in here as well. There was absolutely no brake fluid in here as I popped this open. So I back bled it, found out this one was jammed up. I'm also gonna take the calipers off and free those up. So stay tuned as I go through this thing. Just installed the new master cylinder. New used, I should say. Cover off, see how that looks on the inside. After I go through the lines, the first thing I'll do is bleed the master cylinder first with the lines disconnected. Just make sure there's no air in the master cylinder. That one looks good. Fluid in there. Okay. Good. And if you do order these used, I buy them off of eBay, make sure the screws are loose and this isn't dried out in the center. I bought a couple of these and the guy's like, oh yeah, it works good. Couldn't get the screws out, they were stripped out. Finally got them out. It was dry as a bone, basically it looked like the other one. It looked horrible on the inside. There's one of them I bought off of eBay. Looks like shit. So I got this master cylinder off a reliable seller. I believe it was Dan's ATV salvage or something like that. Bought from him a bunch of times. I'm gonna go through to take off the caliper. So what I would do is take the bolt off to free this line up. And then it's a half inch socket on each side to pull that off. Usually a tie wrap up here too, holding everything together. I got a couple of them. There's two bolts in the back. There you go. Take a C-clamp and squish it. All right, so what I like to do is, this has been sitting for a while, well, I could even grab an air gun, blow this off. Grab a little PB blaster, spray that. All right, it's lubed up. I'll squish the cylinder in. If I have to put a lot of pressure on this, then I know it's seized up. Oh, we're good. There wasn't much fluid in there, even though I back bled it, so that's making me wonder if there's no fluid running through that line. So that's squished in. Now, there's a couple things you can do. You can take the brake line off, blow air through it. I use a really thin piano string or right now all I've got is guitar wire. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove this. And if you can see here, the J box is right here. So I'm gonna unbolt it from there and pull that line completely out. Okay guys, I got the line removed. I'll run a piece of guitar string through here. Yep. I did blow air through it and it did seem a little jammed up. I'm gonna run this through, try to clean it up, that way I don't have to replace it. Here, got it all the way through. There we go. Got all both ends, got the line cleaned. There's a couple things you could do. You could spray a little WD-40 in, because the inner liner of this does get a little rusted and corroded. I'm gonna try blowing some air through it first, and then maybe do that next. All right guys, so I found the problem. I took the upper hose off the J box right here. That goes up to the handbrake. It's got the banjo style opening on the top. So I ran a piece of guitar wire through that line right there. That was good. It turned out it was this one. The one going up to here. This part was jammed up. I tried running a wire through here. No go, even sprayed some WD-40 through it. Nothing. Fortunate I deal with all these Polaris parts. I actually have another line right here. I blew some WD-40 and some air through it and it's blowing out completely. So I'm gonna hook that up and see if I get pressure. Okay, so I've gone through the calipers, make sure the lines are clean, replaced the upper brake line going to the master cylinder. Now I'm gonna take a syringe and back bleed everything back into the master cylinder. All the lines are pretty much empty. So I'm gonna show you how this works. It works really good. Crack open the bleeder screw. And you put this in the bleeder screw. And you just squeeze it. Oh, I can hear the master cylinder bubbling. And right when I get to the end, I shut it off before any air comes in. That way I got fluid in the lines, the air is pushing that back up through the master cylinder. And then I'll do the other side, and then the back also. Okay, so now I back bled the front lines. You can see the master cylinder actually fill up. I did bleed the master cylinder before I hooked up the line. So now I'm just gonna kind of squeeze the brakes a little bit. The rest of the air bubbles out. I have to do this a couple times. I do have the cylinders pushed in on the calipers, so this might take a while. I actually hear the back working right now. Now if you were to bleed it the other direction, you know, guys put like a hose on the bleeder screw and into a jar of brake fluid. Right now there'd be bubbles popping out of here. Because I back bled everything, I got all the air out instantly. And right now I'm just trying to get fluid everywhere. And I haven't back bled the back brakes, but it sounds like they're working. So once I get the fronts to tighten up, then I'll do the back. I don't know if that's the correct way. Usually you do the furthest line back first, But I like to do the fronts and then get to the back. I'm just gonna keep pumping away on this. I might have to bleed the backs, maybe re-bleed the fronts. See how things go. All right, so I found problem number two. Rear brake caliper was leaking. That's why I heard it clamping. And also there are absolutely no brake pads left on here. If you look right here, it's like metal to metal. So I'm gonna be replacing that. And that should cure my problem. I got fluid running through all the lines. It's pumping up good. I'm gonna replace that, back bleed those lines, and that should be it. Because yeah, as I was filling up the foot pedal reservoir, your foot pedal here, there's a reservoir right here you gotta fill up. Started pumping that up, and when I pumped that up, it actually filled back into the master cylinder reservoir up on top. And I came back here, just gonna crack the bleeder valve open, and I noticed the puddle. So I think once I take care of that, I should have the brakes all done, nice and tight, no air leaks, no line stoppages, and this bad boy will be ready to go. So I hope this video helped you guys out. That's how I bleed a system. I back bleed it. About 3 years ago I had videos on how I would crack open the bleeder screw, have a rubber hose going into a jar, and then pump the handbrake just to get all the air out of the lines. That worked great. That is one way to do it. If you guys don't have a syringe or anything, it does take longer. I found out that back bleeding with that syringe works really good, because basically you're pushing all the air out through the master cylinder handbrake up on top. All right, guys, I gotta get a replacement part and some brake pads, and this bad boy will be done. Hope you like this video. Hit the thumbs up if you liked it, and like always, till next time.